I want to first give a shout out to a bunch of really advanced, really cool reference applications, which we've been developing for this off-road space for heavy machinery. All of these examples are available to the public, so you can just download them. They form a really good basis to start your own modeling. So they give a very good reference examples for an excavator, wheel loader, and tracked vehicles. They also go beyond simply the physical modeling. They also offer tools for optimization and design. For example, the wheel loader also has functionality to optimize the continuous variable transmission. And we'll see for the excavator what else you can do except only modeling and simulating the dynamics in the next few slides. So first question is, how do we get to our model in Simulink? We start from a CAD model. You see on the left here, this is from SolidWorks. We have import workflows for pretty much any CAD tool out there. For SolidWorks, there's a simple plugin which you can call, and it's going to transfer your CAD model into a Simscape multibody model. So it's going to port over all your parts. It's going to grab the meshes. It's going to use the mates in the CAD model to create the joints. And it saves a lot of work, essentially. It's not quite a one-step process. You still need to do some manual processing, but it saves a lot of work compared to starting from blank canvas. If you want to learn more about how this actually goes, this workflow, then here's a small QR code and a video by some colleagues of ours. They really demonstrate nicely how these import workflows function. And once you have this model imported, you can do a bunch of things. You can test integrated hydraulic, mechanical, electrical designs. You can review the machine behavior. So there's a small 3D representation of our excavator down here. And of course, you can verify the machine performance. So here, for example, we're looking at the various forces acting on our swing, boom, and stick. We don't only have physical model though. We can also extend it with the controller, with our operator inputs, and we can create a simulation model that really matches a real system architecture. The physical model, it contains the mechanical parts, which we've gotten from CAD. It also incorporates hydraulic actuators. So we have the pumps and the valves, which are used to actuate the cylinders. And it can be used, for example, to calculate performance metrics following ISO standards. So that's what's being done in our reference example. There is an international standard that specifies how to measure digging forces, for example. So it enables easier comparison between different excavators. It's usually reported on the data sheets. So that's where we can get that from. And if you're designing that, you need to somehow calculate these. So we created an app in this example that helps the user to calculate and report those forces. So you can change and optimize the geometry of your excavator arm. You can change the pin locations. Then you can run your physical simulation model. It's going to calculate those forces and going to present them nicely here. So we created this nice app here, which helps the user to calculate and report those digging forces. So you can play with the geometry of your excavator arm. You can change the location of the pins. And then it's going to run this physical dynamic simulation. It's going to calculate the necessary forces according to the standard and display them in this nice overview. Another application of the physical model would be efficiency calculations. For example, gravity can be used to essentially save energy when the excavator arm is moving down. So there are periods, for example, here of negative energy, which we see in this graph on the right-hand side. This shows where gravity helps to lower the arm, and we don't need to expend extra energy for that. And we can do some detailed calculations, which show that the efficiency is indeed higher if we use regeneration valves. And it also shows us by how much. So we can perform trade-off studies or optimize the design again. Another very relevant topic for off-road machinery is simulation of ground contact. And here we show one example of how to do that by co-simulating with discrete element methods. So on the right-hand side, you see this is done with this free particle simulation tool, which is a software that really allows to do high fidelity simulation of contact between our shovel and rocks, gravel, sand, things like this. Now, usually discrete element method calculations, they take a very long time. So here what was done, this was computed offline. And then essentially a playback was co-simulated with Simlink to enable a real-time simulation of ground contact.